Hey guys, Alex from VIA here again, and in this video, we're gonna set up the ADAS portion of your D700. It's just as quick, it's just as easy as the last step. Let's get into it.
In the last video, we uploaded a photo so that the system will recognize Alex Wu's face and use it as his personal ID. In this video, we are going to complete the ADAS calibration. By the end of the video, you will have a green check mark here as well.
Okay, we're back in the car and we're setting up the ADAS portion of the D700. Just like before, sign on to the Wi-Fi and then open the app. The only difference is now this time, you're going to click the left icon that is still red. Okay, the first thing it will ask you for are several measurements, the vehicle height, the distance from the camera to the roof, and so on. And so this is when you will need your tape measure. Some of this information can be found in your car's owner manual, and you can also set it up on the computer beforehand if you wish. In our case, we're going to take some measurements right now. Okay, once you have input all your measurements, just press OK. So we've picked a spot that you can see the ocean and we can see a clear view of the horizon. So try to find a place near you that has the most open area as possible. And then just take the camera and position it so that it's on the horizon. And once you've done that, press calibration. Okay, once you've adjusted the camera height for your horizon, you need to start driving on a road and try to pick a road that has the most clearly marked lines on either side of the lane.
While you're driving, have your co-pilot watch the screen to make sure the calibration process completes successfully. The whole process should take anywhere from 30 seconds to 1 minute, depending on the environment.
ADAS calibration complete.
So now, if we look on the computer in the vehicle profile, we can see the ADAS calibration has a green check mark. And if we click on Edit Vehicle, we can actually enable some of these features. So let's go ahead and enable Lane Departure Warning, Forward Collision Warning, or Driver Monitoring System. It should be noted, however, that you must choose between FCW and DMS. You cannot yet have both of these enabled at the same time. It's just a technological limitation. And that's it. Don't forget to save before you exit.
And that's all there is to it. Now all the AI features on your D700 are ready to use. See you next time.